everyone, this is Shariq again and welcome back to Globetrotted Arabic. We were just recording a lesson from the fruits and vegetables shop from the town of Anjar in Lebanon. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel before I start my lesson and also follow me on Instagram. So we are in the car with my mom and her friends. This is Tante Sola, she's also like my second mom, and Tante Asho here. So I thought this is a perfect opportunity to teach you one Lebanese Arabic expression because these two in the front have been talking Armenian all the time. And Tante Sola here, she doesn't speak Armenian, she is just Lebanese, she's not Lebanese Armenian. So she doesn't understand anything. So she goes yes, or she just learned one Armenian word, which is ayo. So I'm gonna teach you the sentence, the expression actually. Actually, معلي فيكم تحكوا فيكم تنزل عادي تصرفوا عادي انزلوا اعملوا اللي بدكم اياه. So I wanted to teach you the expression مثل الأطرش بالزفة. مثل الأطرش بيضحكوا. They are laughing. مثل الأطرش بالزفة. So أطرش in Arabic means deaf. زفة is, how can I explain that? You know in wedding parties when there is a dance troupe comes and they do this big huge dance and it's so loud? And it's usually we do it at the beginning of the party, like they enter the party with a big group of dancers and then the bride and groom follow. So that's a zaffe. We do it almost in every wedding in Lebanon. So when I say mitl, al-atrash bizzaffe, mitl means like, just like. Al-atrash, the deaf, and then bil-zaffe, bil, in the, and zaffe, which means this traditional dance, wedding dance. Okay, so what does this mean when I say مثل الأطرش بالزفة? It means somebody who is in the middle of something and they don't understand anything, just like a deaf person basically who is in a wedding and who is not hearing any of the loud music and the dance, so he wouldn't hear it. So that's where this expression comes from. If you're not understanding anything. So now Tante Sola, for example, they just left the car. Now Tante Sola, for example, she was sitting here not understanding anything. It's a perfect time to say مثل الأطرش بالزفة. It's a fixed expression, whether it's masculine or feminine, whether you're talking about yourself or you're talking about somebody else, you just throw the sentence مثل الأطرش بالزفة. Also, another perfect scenario where you can use this expression, for example, if you're in a classroom and your teacher is explaining something and you're not understanding anything, you can say أنا مثل الأطرش بالزفة. Or maybe, for example, if I'm teaching you these Arabic lessons and you're not understanding them, you can say مثل الأطرش بالزفة, أنا مثل الأطرش بالزفة. But there's something you need to be careful of. So for example, when I was breaking it down, I was saying مثل الأطرش بالزفة. But with liaisons, we're not going to pronounce it that way. We have to say مثل الأطرش بالزفة. I'm not saying بالزفة. Why? Because the word زفة starts with the ز, زين. Okay? And all the words in Arabic that start with a ز, when I have a L before it, for example, in this case, بالزفة, I don't pronounce the L, I say بالزفة. Now, if you pronounce it, it's fine, it's not the end of the world, even if you say it, it's not a big mistake, it's not wrong, it just sounds a little bit less native, that's all. So it's better if you say مثل الأطرش بالزفة. That's it for today, thank you very, very much, and I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you soon in another lesson with Globetrot with Arabic. Take care, see you, bye! شجر صنوبر شو حلوة هالطريق بتخففي هون شوي تنطقر شو هيدي كنيسة كتير حلوة. هيدي كنيسة أرمنية. This is an Armenian church. كتير حلوة. It's very beautiful. Okay. Merci.
I'm just making them drive and work for me. These ladies, my mom and her friends.
Okay.